Here's the rundown of some of the best in the city scene this week. We're sampling the flavors of the world in 30 minutes, from Japanese and Korean cuisines to European fares, plus a taste of the Mediterranean and some Asian staples. The countdown starts now, so get ready as we explore the cityscape. Hi guys, I'm Fimela Baranda, your guide to the urban jungle. This week, we're going around the metro to experience various cuisines the world has to offer. Let's start with some Japanese fare. Watch this. There's really nothing like the smell and taste of a perfectly grilled piece of meat. Just the thought of it is enough to make one's mouth water. I recently visited the newly opened Tajimaya at One Rockwell to have some authentic yakiniku, which in Japanese basically means grilled meat. While the space itself is large, seating is limited, partly because of the special yakiniku tables and partitions that separate your table from the rest of the diners, giving your own personal space, which I personally like. I'm so thrilled to try Tajimaya out. They claim to be an authentic Japanese yakiniku restaurant, and I'm about to find out what that means. But before I try their main dishes, I would like to try their appetizers. I found that the appetizers set up the dining experience pretty well with its variety of flavors. Some of the must-tries on the menu will be the light pickle set, as well as the hot pickle set, which kind of reminds me of kimchi. The tomato sarada is drizzled with sesame dressing, a very light and refreshing taste palette. And of course, they have their signature Tajimaya tamagoyaki. It's actually fried egg roll with beef inside. It's really good. Actually, for the appetizer, I recommend that you order also the tamagoyaki with the hot pickle set and the light, so it really complements each other. Now for some mains. Kazuya here is going to help me cook my feast.
The first is the special beef tongue.
Q-tang.
For the special beef tongue, yes. You just dip it in lemon.
Lemon juice only.
Okay, I'm excited. It's only marinated with in sesame, salt, and pepper.
Salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper only.
Yes.
It's really good. Very good.
Very good. Thank you.
Very good. This one is their pork boneless short ribs. Is it ready? Ooh, look at the fat. Yummy.
So this one, I'm going to try the U.S. beef boneless short ribs.
Yes.
And many Japanese restaurants also serve sake. And this one is a very special sake because it has gold flakes. Wow. Really compliments the yakiniku meat. This is your special meat here, which is the wagyu boneless short ribs, and it's marinated in salt and pepper, and you eat it with just wasabi. The wagyu short ribs just melts in your mouth. It's gone. What happened? It's gone. Tajimaya makes use of charcoal to grill meats. It may look old school, but I found that the charcoal adds an extra layer of flavor to it. The restaurant also boasts of serving only high quality meats like US Angus and grade 5 Japanese Wagyu. And that's a definite plus in my book, because the meat comes out tender and very flavorful. There are different ways to enjoy your yakiniku, by wrapping it in lettuce, dipping it in special yakiniku sauce, or as is. And any way you bite into it is decidedly awesome. Domo arigato, Kazuya!
Do itashimashite.
I'm definitely coming back for their special wagyu boneless short ribs. It melts in your mouth and it's really good. And of course, for their sake. Kampai. More cuisines from around the world when we return. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. Welcome back to Cityscape. The flavors of Europe have greatly influenced our cuisine. That is why there are so many restaurants that offer dishes from the different regions of Europe. Comfort food. This is probably the in thing nowadays. And even the dishes from Europe have their own version. This is what you'll get in Fork.
It's basically comfort European because it's all dishes you can cook at home, but we serve it special, in a special way. Mostly Spanish. As the restaurant started, it was all European. And then as the menu developed, I focused on the Spanish cuisine because it's closest to the palate of Filipinos.
Spanish cuisine is described as very flavorful, but here in Fork, it's all about balance.
You'll notice that from your appetizer, main entree, and dessert, you'll have this feeling that you catered all sense of tastes. Because sometimes, normally, you eat soup. You're looking for something salty after. After salty, you're looking for something sweet. So basically, all the six senses of your tongue are catered after the whole course meal.
For the soup, I had the popular French onion soup. It's really perfect. The cheese is so gooey. And because I don't really like the oniony taste, but this one is already cooked, so it's caramelized. Yeah. It's perfect. Spanish signature dish paella valenciana is one of the top selling dishes here. Okay, I'm gonna have a perfect bite.
How is it? Good?
Good. It's very tasty. I can really taste all the Spanish spices.
As well as the lamb chops with potato gratin. With mint jelly and demi-glace on the side.
I love the mint jelly. It's just right. The sweetness is just right.
And it's so strong.
Very important is that the lamb is very tender.
Yes.
For those who have sweet tooth,
try the Fork Special, vanilla ice cream with orange juice, grenadine, topped with caramel popcorn. So expect a play on your taste buds with the sweetness, saltiness, and sour hint.
I heard there's a story in this very, very good dessert.
Yes, actually it was a mistake because we ran out of desserts one day. Okay. So what I did was I made them buy popcorn and I just made that concoction and people liked it. Mm-hmm. So I decided to put it on the menu.
If only all mistakes tasted this good. If you have time left and a little bit of space in your stomach, have a drink or two. Fork serves good old classic mojito and margarita. This quaint restaurant is a nice place to unwind while savoring the lusciousness of European comfort food. One of Makati's best-kept secrets now comes to the north of the metro, bringing its signature Italian dishes under a new name, Pasteleria La Terrazza Cafe.
The main company is La Nuova. It's in Forbes Park. It's across the San Antonio Church. We've been there for over 15 years. And then we partnered up with some Italian chefs. So they trained our people, and then we opened La Nuova, and we've been doing well. Then my mom asked me, "Oh, you want to open up here?" So, exacto, Robinson's opened up a mall, so we grabbed the chance and we got a space, and here we are. This is our new venture.
The restaurant prides itself with using imported quality ingredients to bring you authentic flavors of Italy.
Generally, it's just the Italian dishes, so we choose from different regions and then we just try to offer it little by little in the store. So every month or every 2 months, we come up with new dishes. But we're known for the tartufo. It's we use Parma ham and we use truffle oil and truffle cream. Then we also have the linguine salmon with caviar. And we also have this pizza La Terrazza. It's pizza with spinach and chorizo. Even the kids, they learn how to eat their veggies. When they try that, they really like it.
Pasta lovers will surely have a blast with a variety of pasta dishes to choose from. Olive oil-based vongole al vino bianco with baby clams and aglio olio con gamberetti topped with chili shrimp. Tomato-based pescatora salsa pomodoro. There are also a wide array of cream-based pastas like the tartufo. And if you love steak, satisfy your craving with the filetto di manzo. Grilled beef tenderloin in porcini mushroom sauce served with vegetables. Pasteleria La Terrazza is a great addition to the growing number of Italian restaurants in the metro, giving diners more food options to choose from.
Then there's Mediterranean. Greek cuisine is just one of the many restos that offer this kind of cuisine, and I check it out to sample some of its dishes.
Mediterranean cuisine is something that's still a mystery for most Pinoys. So to help demystify it a little bit, I decided to visit Greek cuisine, a resto that's been getting a lot of buzz lately. Dishes here are a bit pricey, but with servings this big, you know that it's good value for your money.
So Casey, I'm about to try two of your best-selling salads.
I couldn't decide which one I liked more, the watercress blue cheese salad or the grilled cheese souvlaki salad. think I'm going to declare this one a tie. These hefty salads are so filling, you can actually choose to end your meal with it. But if you're still hungry, you can also have some gyros to go with your salad. Or some spanakopita or spinach pie. But for the hungry stomachs, you can have some tantalizing meat dishes.
Well, I can see that the Greeks love their meat or their protein, and one of their favorite meats is
the lamb.
Another thing that I liked about Greek cuisine's menu is that each entree comes with your choice of side dish. You can choose to have some noodles like watercress pasta dish, or some emistes or stuffed pepper with rice for a bit of a kick. Or you can go in my favorite Greek dish, the moussaka. Better leave some room for dessert, like Greeka's famous baklava.
Tweak the flavors to match the market. Because if it's Greek, it's really normally clean or like lemony. But we added a few twists, of course, so that it's more acceptable to the Filipino palate. I feel that here in Greeka Cucina, given that our family loves to eat and we really pride ourselves in value for money, I believe it's a worthwhile try because we have huge servings to serve for like a family or the barkada. It's worth a shot because it's you get your full meal together with a siding, and it's really to share. So I advise people to go here with big groups so that they can try a lot of different things. So there, I think it's value for money. Basically, it boils down to that.
Groups of friends and couples on romantic dates alike all troop here, not just for the relaxed ambiance and quiet romantic setting, but because the food is genuinely delicious. And if you believe the saying that one way to know a country's culture is by eating its food, then I for one learned a lot about Greece today.
After the break, we're heading to the Southeast Asian region for more Epicurean adventure. Cityscape will return in a bit. You're still watching Cityscape and more of the best in the metro. Cuisines from Southeast Asia like Singaporean, Vietnamese, Khmer, and Thai are what you can sample in the newly opened Koh Samui. Let's see how it fares. I'm craving for a bit of Asian flavors and I think I've come to the right place. It's called Koh Samui. Not only do they serve Thai dishes, but they've also got some Chinese, Singaporean, Malaysian, and Vietnamese food thrown into the mix. Sounds interesting, right? Let's check it out.
Named after an island in Thailand, the interiors of Koh Samui are what you'd expect to see in a Thai restaurant. Elephant sculptures and ornate lamps hanging from the ceiling. But don't be intimidated by all of the opulence, because the owners actually built the restaurant with relaxation in mind. The seats are as plush and comfy as they are luxe. Though Koh Samui serves food from the different Southeast Asian countries, I was in the mood for a Thai feast. The Thai dishes here come from the southern region of Thailand, a little bit sweet and healthier as compared to the northern region cuisine. To start off your meal, have the three fortune platter, which is composed of pho pya, chicken pandan, and Spanish mackerel fish cakes. Other must-tries include the deep-fried shrimp cake, and for soups, of course, the tom yum goong is your best bet. Got just the right amount of kick to it, and it's a real crowd pleaser as expected. For the main course, I got to have a mouthful of the rich golden curry crab.
The yellow curry crab is so flavorful that it's best to have it with plain rice.
You can also choose to get the very popular and photogenic pineapple rice.